Welcome to the next practical session of embedded software testing. Today we will try to focus on the exercise 3, that is on coverage testing tools for unit testing. So we know that in embedded software testing we have the life cycle such as V model, where right from system requirements to software requirements, requirement analysis, high level design, low level design, and the code on the one side, and on the other side we have system validation, system integration, hardware software integration, and software software integration testing on par with the high level design and the unit testing in terms of detailed design or low level design that we have. And on par with this detailed design and low level testing, we have the implementation of the code that is also required. So that is what we will try to do with the unit testing. So what basically we do with the coverage testing tool is something like we start with the instrumented and non-instrumented based execution. So the focus is to cover all the top level requirements, whether it is implemented or not implemented. Then we will generate the report and see whether it is covering 100% or not. So that is what the purpose of the unit testing we have. So basically objective of software testing is to demonstrate the software satisfies the requirements. So we will try to see how the tool is used. Example tool that we pick up today is LDR unit. It is a unit testing tool. Also followed by that we will try to see the structural coverage report analysis, how it gets generated. So far in our theoretical sessions earlier we studied about black box testing, white box testing, in terms of testing methods. We know that three levels of system testing, integration testing and unit testing that can be done. So unit testing we will try to focus on specific units. We know that we have stubs and drivers that we need to live with, so we will try to touch base on that part. So there are bottom up approach, top down approach. So top down approach, we are trying to test a higher level module with the help of stubs or the for the particular unit which is under interest for us to test it, right. So we have suppose F1, F2, F3, F4, 4 .c files or the C files that are to be tested initially, and we are trying to test as a complete unit. So we will do first one under focus as the F1.c, F2, F3, F4c dot is the stubbed, because F1C is of interest for us. Similarly what we are doing for F2 we are going to do for F1. So likewise we are going to have the stubs created. So likewise we have specific interfaces sometimes that also need to be addressed. So those interfaces are also stubbed, something like subsystems suppose. So for unit testing there is a dependency on these subsystems or the subunits or any interface units. So we are going to have a stubs, and the stubs will have basically the parameters that are required to pass on, and the parameters or the return values or the variables that are required to return. So with the help of that we will develop it, and how it can be automated then also some tools will take up. If that cannot be automated, then in that case we have to do a manual verification of the same. So basically for low level testing, what we do is we look for SDD or low level design, also called software design document, at its low level, not the high level, because that will talk about all the lowest possible design algorithms. Some embedded systems will have a pseudocode, so in generic, and that will be implemented in the code. So along with SDD we also need the code, because we need to instrument and non-instrument, etc. So basically we will try to cover all that partition equivalence, boundary, robustness, with all these ranges and all that with the provided specification. And what we try to do is non-instrumented target object code we will try to execute on the target, basically that we will see in another session where the target based execution is taking care. But also we will try to go through if possible today, and all the requirements functional tests will be done with some limited values on the target or the simulated target, where actually there is a dependence in a target that is needed, so we cannot or it may be difficult to instrument. And robustness also will do that, and we will try to get the results. Similarly on the host side, we have the instrumented native, it is called as our instrumented host object code. Finally we have to compile the instrumented source code along with the original source code to create a target object code, and we will be running that, and we will be passing on all the values that we require for normal range, robustness, etc., and all the requirements and robustness test cases are compared the results along with the above one. So combining these together, combining both this, we are going to come up with the coverage. So that is what we do with the coverage analysis with the both instrumented and non-instrumented unit testing. Okay. So in terms of DO on SynetB, that is a aerospace standards, it is one of the stringent standards that has to be adopted. So basically this talks about structural coverage and analysis, and the objectives will be to ensure the structural coverage, that is each source code branch is executed at least once. That means we have source code with branches and conditions, right? So every branch has to be, in terms of statement or decision, has to be executed on the target or on the separation, whatever the way you want. So that execution drive will be done with the tool basically. So we will have test cases created for the requirements basically, because the requirements will tell about the values, right? So those values have to be driving these branches and decisions to have the coverage and robustness. So DO on SynetB requirement is that to ensure the statement, decision, modified condition, decision coverage, that we need to take care of. To identify the dead code also is one of the important objective. So statement coverage, decision coverage, modified MCDC, it is called as, that is independency of the different values at the input level, as well as the output level, have to be adhered that is what we do with the DeonSonnet V. And also dead code needs to be isolated, it should be removed basically. Analysis must be performed to assess the effect and the need of second time verification. If we are going to remove the dead code and are we really requiring to execute, we may require to do it because regression testing is necessary in that case where the impacted tests need to be re-verified or retested. So some of the examples of robustness are something like divide by 0, that is also one of the robustness where how the code is going to behave for this situation, and to verify the component behavior in front of an overflow for a local data, how it is going to behave, or something like negative square root, some impossible operation we will also try. At any case, software should have a proper path to have an known or determined execution, that is what we need to verify. So that these things might not have been specified in the design document or low level design document, but there should be a way to figure it out. Okay, so basically low level testing, the lowest level entity, most independent unit within its boundaries we are going to have it. So we need input at detailed design as detailed design, and the testing process is unit testing, and the output will be the test report and the coverage report, so which will tell how much is covered in terms of branches and statements. So basically we are trying to cover the functionality of the model, and at the same time its robustness also will be verified. So the best way to do this is with using the code itself, you do it. So it is not just try to do the unit testing without the help of the code with the only design. So the main input for a tester to perform the unit test is the software design document and not the source code. Basically design document is the input for him, based on that he has to drive the value. Where he is going to drive the value is the input as code. So with the code as input, the requirements are not tested and mismatch between detailed design and code cannot be detected sometimes. So unit testing we may have to take care for the those situations. Okay, so there are different tools like RTRT, Quantata, Vectorcast, CTB, LDRA, like this. So we will try to go through the LDRA tool, how they use it, because these are all available in net. Actually I have downloaded and we can use it as a reference.